so honored to receive this award in front of such amazing actors that I admire.
I'd like to say as little as possible here because the film is best when you go into it cold. I'd like to say as little as possible here because the film is best when you go into it cold.
I went in not knowing what the movie was about and just heard buzz that this was great. And I loved it. I loved it because I don't want to spoil anything. It's hard to describe the movie.
Yeah.
How do you describe Parasite?
뭐 나도 여기서 되도록 말을 안 하고 싶어요. 스토리를 모르고 가서 봐야 재밌거든요.
I like to say as little as possible here because the film is best when you go into it cold.
Anyway,
well, this is a talk show, so you have to say something.
가족 얘기예요. 가난한 가족 애가 부잣집에 과외하러 가면서 이제 벌어지는 얘기예요.
It's a story about family. The son goes into a rich house as a tutor, and the story unfolds from there.
Here's what made me laugh. I read that it got an 8-minute standing ovation for the film.
Yeah.
Right? 8 minutes of people clapping. Mm. And then you got up, and all you said was, thank you, let's all go home. What happened? Why?
Because... actually, the screening was very late night. It was almost midnight, and the 기립박수가 되게 길게 이어지는데 저랑 배우들이 다 되게 배가 고팠어요. 저녁을 제대로 못 먹어가지고.
So the standing ovation lasted very long, but the actors and I were very hungry because we couldn't eat dinner.
So actually, me and actors all 너무 배고파. 그게 자막으로 들어가서 나왔어요. I'm so hungry라고.
We all were saying to each other, we're so hungry, and they ended up subtitling it in the video that was later.
No, yes. No!
But the applause never stops, so finally I said, yeah, let's go home.
I think that's great.
Actually, the climax, 여러분들 보기, 와, 저 샷은 정말 중요하다 싶은 것들. 사실은 되게 빨리 찍었어요, 솔직히 말하면. 그 떼약볕이라고 하죠. 떼약볕을 어떻게 통역하실래요? 이거 그 단어가 있겠지. 정말 떼약볕, 정말 강한 떼약볕에서 그 신을 찍어야 된다라고 저랑 우리 그 DP는 촬영 감독은 처음부터 이제 생각을 했었거든요. 그 지하에서 몇 년간 지냈던 남자가 마침내 그 엄청난 햇빛 아래 나와서 그 유혈극을 펼치는 거니까. 그래서 정말 더더욱 그런 힘든 날씨였죠.
So all those scenes, that shots that look very important in the climactic sequence, we actually shot them very fast. And the DP and I, we were very insistent from the beginning that this scene had to take place under intense sunlight. And so that's why we chose that day. And because essentially that scene is about this man who had been living in this bunker for years, coming out all of a sudden to begin this bloodbath. And that's why we had to shoot in such a hot day. So all those scenes, that shots that look very important in the climactic sequence, we actually shot them very fast. And the DP and I, we were very insistent from the beginning that this scene had to take place under intense sunlight. And so that's why we chose that day. And because essentially that scene is about this man who had been living in this bunker for years, coming out all of a sudden to begin this bloodbath. And that's why we had to shoot in such a hot day. Give you guys a brief context on why they were laughing. Director Bong was trying to explain a line from The Sun and called him the main character and apologized to Song over here for calling him the main character. But what Director Bong was saying is, you know, you have The Sun.
Song, when you read the screenplay for the first time, what did you think?
누가 주인공일까? 이런 생각을 제가 제일 많이 했어요.
The thought that I had the most is who is the main protagonist.
그래서 저 돌 들고 있는 저 아들 놈이 아주 근소한 차이로 저보다 분량이 조금 많은데 자기가 주인공이라고 막 떠들고 지금 다 돌아다니고 있는데 영화 보셔서 아시겠지만 누가 주인공? 제가 주인공 맞죠? 예.
So my son, who's holding up the rock over there, has a little bit more screen time than I do in the film. So he's been going around saying that he's the main character, main protagonist. But you've all seen the film. Who is the main protagonist? It's him.
This man.
So the rock, what was the what's the metaphor? What's the significance of the rock? It keeps popping up.
그냥 돌이에요.
It's just a rock.
아니 보통 그
You don't understand. Everyone here, they're going to be like, what's the meaning of the rock? People will write 2,000 word essays on the rock, and it's just a rock.
아이고 플라스 아니 저 말랑말랑한 것도 만들었지 우리가 안전한 소품으로 물론. 예.
Of course, it was rubbery and soft. It was just a prop when we were shooting the film.
네, 그 주인공이 그러잖아요. 그 메타포리컬하다고 주인공이 저기 주인공이 아니구나 참. 아, 주인공 아틀레미가 죄송합니다 형님. 아, 그 이 들고서 메타포리컬하다고 하잖아요. 그래서 그 보통은 이제 스콧 당신처럼 이렇게 기자나 평론가 분들이 뭐 영화를 보고 나서 상징적이다 이렇게 말하는 건데 극중 인물이 지가 지 입으로 상징적이다라고 하고 자빠졌는데. 예.
So to give you guys a brief context on why they were laughing, Director Bong was trying to explain a line from The Sun and called him the main character and apologized to Song over here for calling him the main character. But what Director Bong was saying is, you know, you have The Sun, the Sun character, say within the film, this is so metaphorical. And usually that's something the reporter or a critic say when discussing the metaphors of the film, but here you have the character announcing it on screen. I created my first feature film in 1999, and ever since I graduated film school and joined the directing team marking the slate, it's been 26 years since I've been working as a filmmaker.
네, 그 가장 어려웠고 또 이제 그래서 가장 마지막에 이제 완성. 가장 마지막에 이제 한 캐스팅이 이제 그 지하실의 남자 그 박명훈이란 배우인데 그 벙커에 있는 그 남편 워낙 그 독특한 역할이고 약간 정상과 비정상 사이를 왔다 갔다 하는 인물이라서 그리고 관객들에게 알려지지 않은 배우를 캐스팅해야 했기 때문에 제일 힘들었었어요. 근데 그분 제가 좋아했던 어떤 인디 영화의 중요한 서포팅 롤로 나왔던 분이라서 최종적으로 캐스팅할 수 있었던 그분을 이제 캐스팅하면서 전체 퍼즐이 딱 이 앙상블의 마지막 퍼즐이 딱 완성이 됐었죠.
Five, four, three, two, one.
So the most difficult character to cast and the last one to join the ensemble was the man of the in the bunker. The actor's name is Park Myung-hoon, and it was difficult to cast this character because the character itself is so unique, and you know he goes back and forth between being normal and being very abnormal. And another difficulty was having to cast an unknown actor that the public wasn't familiar with. But thankfully, he played a very important supporting role in an indie film that I liked, so I ultimately decided to cast him. And once he joined, it felt like all the puzzle pieces came together.
가난한 자와 부자, 자본주의에 관한 얘기인데 미국이야말로 뭐 자본주의의 심장 같은 나라니까 논쟁적이고 뜨거운 반응이 있을 수밖에 없겠다는 생각이 또 들었고요. 예.
Because this film is about the rich and poor, and essentially about capitalism, and the U.S. is the heart of capitalism. So I thought it was natural to gain such an explosive response.
그리고 이런 정치적인 메시지나 사회적인 어떤 주제도 있지만 그것을 아주 매력적이고 관객들이 친근하게 받아들일 수 있게 전해주는 우리 또 뛰어난 그 배우들의 매력이 어필됐기 때문에 미국 관객들의 또 그런 좋은 반응이 있었던 것이 아닌가라고 생각하고 있습니다.
And while Parasite has these political, social messages and themes, the reason why the story felt so familiar to the U.S. audience is, I think, thanks to the incredible charm that these actors have.
그레이다 아너. 그 기생충이라는 영화는 이제 제목이 기생충인데 사실은 이제 영화 내용 보셔서 아시겠지만 우리가 어떻게 살아가면 좋을까라는 공생에 관한 영화라고 생각합니다.
Although Parasite, the title is Parasite, I think the story is about coexistence and how we can all live together.
그래서 thank you. 근데 이렇게 상징적으로 그리고 정말 의미가 있는 앙상블의 최고예상을 받으니까 우리가 영화를 잘못 만들지는 않았구나라는 생각이 듭니다. 예.
But to be honored with the Best Ensemble Award, it occurs to me that maybe we haven't created such a bad movie.
오늘 이렇게 존경하는 대배우님들 앞에서 이렇게 큰 상을 받게 해서 너무 영광스럽고 오늘의 이 아름다운 기억을 영원히 기억하겠습니다. 대단히 감사합니다.
I am so honored to receive this award in front of such amazing actors that I admire. I will never forget this beautiful night. Thank you so much.